We can start if we like now. Okay.
Yeah, okay, we can start. So,
Okay. Hello, everybody.
please.
Has everybody with me now? I think
Yes.
everybody is with me. Today is our sixth lecture. Today is our sixth lecture with the support of our great professor Paul Fu. Today we are going to talk about some basic equation in potential problems and the elasticity problems, and we'll talk about the C matrix. I always in the previous lecture, in the previous lectures, I always ask you to believe me in many things. The first thing is that I asked you to believe me in it, which is, for example, in potential problem. If we go back to potential problem. We knew if we talk about temperature or heat flow or something like that, we knew that nabla square u equal to zero, or actually nabla square u at any point x equal to zero. From where this equation came? This is, we call it the governing equation. So today I want to write from where this equation in part one of the lecture. We will talk about from where these equations came from. For example, if we look at here, we have a room or something like that. And inside this room, we'll take just differential element like that. And the lenses here, we have dx and dy. And when we use the straight d like that, that we mean we have lenses. So we knew from this part, a bit of flow of heat comes from here is equal to Qx, and a bit part came from here equal to Qy, for example. We'll use X and Y here, is not X1 and X2, because it is more easy and more convenient. After that, from here, this part of the flow will go out with Qx plus the additional part the additional increment from this lens, actually. This is what we call it, is dqx by dx qx. Dx by dqx times dx. This is times dx. Why is that? Why this part? Because if we have Qx is a multi-valued function, so we have Qx has variables in x and y direction. So for example, if it is a surface, Qx is a surface. So when we take this x direction, this is y direction, for example. So it is a surface, something like that. This is Qx, a function. Okay. So when what I want is the increment is this derivative, is a partial derivative with respect to x in the x direction. So this is an increment in this direction times the length. So when I use curl d, I define the derivative or the slope in this direction. Okay. When I use the straight d, I define the lengths. In the same way, here, this is, we have qy plus dqy by dy, curly d also, dy. So we can write for any control volume that we have a steady state equation. So we have to write the total value is equal to zero. So the total value is equal to this part minus this part. So we'll cancel this, let us write it qx plus dqx by dx dx, all of this, and this will be multiplied by this length y dy times times the thickness, of the wall. We'll take the thickness of the wall is equal to 1, or something like that, minus qx, this term, here, times dy times 1, plus the same the same in the other direction, the same in the other direction, which is qy plus dqy by dy dy times dx times 1 minus qy times dx times 1. All of that should be equal to 0 for a steady state. For a steady state, all volume in equal to all volume out plus all volume out, all of them are equal to 0. So at the end of the day, this one will be cancelled with this one, and this one will be cancelled with this one. We'll end up to dqx by dx, we'll divide by dx and dy also, plus dqy by dy equal to 0. And we knew that qx is the flux or the heat flow in the x direction, so equal to du by dx, and qy equal du by dy. When we substitute this here, we'll end up to d2u by dx square plus d2u by dy square equal to 0. And this is exactly the potential equation, or nabla square u at any point x equal to 0, or u comma theta theta equal to 0. So this is the first thing I want to talk about it today. This is the first thing I want to talk about it today is the governing equation for potential problem.